I'm Jake Mahoney, and this is the Audio Engineering Society's large rotary-style subwoofer. Our project is a special kind of speaker that plays the same types of frequencies as earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. Just like light, music is a spectrum of frequencies. While there are ultraviolet and infrared frequencies of light that the human eye can't see, there are also ultrasonic and infrasonic frequencies of music that the human ear just doesn't pick up. Think of a dog whistle. The intent of this rotary subwoofer is to generate 1 to 20 Hz infrasonic frequencies at high energy levels. This is a niche that very few speakers can fill, with only one commercially available unit capable of playing true infrasonics. While unhearable frequencies aren't necessarily useful for music, it turns out that many of the environments that we interact with daily have resonance frequencies in this infrasonic range. A speaker capable of generating these infrasonic frequencies is relevant to resonance trials and practical theatric effects. We're currently in McArdle Theater, which has a measured room resonance of approximately 8 Hz. At this resonance, the effect of the rotary subwoofer is amplified, which, when paired with 4 kilowatts of 3-phase power, has the ability to shake walls. I'd like to reiterate that this project was completed through the Audio Engineering Society at MTU. When the team sat down to create a list of design considerations, we settled on 5 main points. For one, we had to ensure that the rotary blades were constrained in the event of a catastrophic failure. Second, we had to minimize unwanted noise and vibration in the system. Third, we had to minimize blade deflection at operating loads. Fourth, we needed to spec the right size motor to keep the angular velocity constant under peak loads. And finally, we needed to ensure that the rotary could use the common forms of single and three-phase power available around campus. The team moved to simulation early in the project to model the dynamic forces and power requirements of the motor and actuator. This early understanding streamlined many conversations about the scope and size of the subwoofer, and these sims also highlighted the peak force conditions during operation. Using FEA, these forces were used to validate the strength of numerous components. With the rotary subwoofer, there's a lot of energy at play every time it spins up, and through this analysis, the team eliminated many weak links that could lead to a catastrophic failure. A thorough failure mode effects analysis was critical for identifying and mitigating operating risks throughout the design process. Highlighted are a few key failure modes that relate to the rotating blade hub, the speaker grill, and the angular linkage. This forethought has especially paid off in the blade design. During trials, a bolt in the linkage system sheared and the blade reverted to a neutral position. This was a design feature implemented because of this failure analysis. Finally, we have budget. This rotary subwoofer was primarily funded through the USG Opportunity Fund, which gave our project a $2,500 grant. Highlighted are some of the larger purchased items, including the AC servo motor, a large block of 6061 for the motor spacer, and a sheet of polycarbonate for the blades. Thank you for your time, and we hope to see you at Design Expo.